In the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, thanks to our friends at Go Providence, Chef Phil Mazzotta is here from Rosalina. We got a Greek salad with Bovis olive oil, right?
Yes.
That's what we got going. Now, good to have you here.
Thanks.
You're making your TV debut today.
I am. I'm very excited.
This is good stuff. Rosalina, great restaurant.
Thank you.
And how are we going to put this all together, and what are the ingredients we need?
The Greek salad or Horiatiki salad in Greece is translated into village salad.
Okay.
So it's a lot of fresh vegetables. We got confrita farm tomatoes, red onions, green peppers, some cucumbers. We also have Didoni feta cheese, which is a lot higher in fat, so it's really creamy.
And that's delicious. What you guys were saying before. You were saying that the feta cheese that we're going to use today for this is probably the best feta cheese you can use and best tasting.
Oh, yeah, by far.
And what makes it that? Because it is higher in fat?
Yeah, it's higher in fat, and we actually get it shipped in from Greece.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, if you're gonna have feta cheese, you want it from Greece.
Go big or go home.
Go big or go home. Also, the olive oil that you're putting on it too. You were telling me about that.
Oh yeah, it's Bovis family olive oil. It's been in the family for over three generations, 150 years. He actually, it's Tom, the owner's cousin.
Oh, okay.
The Katamata region of Greece.
Right.
So they make it. It's organic.
And you can really taste the difference in the flavor from the olive oil that we're going to use today.
By far.
And that really makes the Greek salad.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
All right, so some of the other ingredients that you have over here, just salt and pepper, and what else do you have?
We have oregano, fresh from the mountains of Greece.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, let me give this a... You have to give it some.
Oh, man, it smells great.
Oh, yeah. Katamata olives.
Which I love.
That's what I heard. Capers and pepperoncini peppers.
Okay, so easy enough to do. So we're going to chop all this up, put it together, and also talk about what's going on at the restaurant again, because these guys have been here before. Great restaurant. We will get to that in just a little bit. Back to you.
Back into the kitchen with Will, who I'm assuming has, already eaten all the olives?
I'm saving some for you, because I know how much you love them just as much. All right, we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Thanks to Go Providence. Rosalina is the restaurant. Chef Phil is here. We got a Greek salad with Bovis olive oil on the menu. You get a lot of fresh ingredients.
A lot of fresh
that
ingredients.
That you're chopping up also. You've got the cheese here.
The great cheese.
We're going to talk about that again in just a little bit. What do you want to do right now?
Well, we're going to start just prepping the salad. We're going to cut some vegetables. We got the green pepper. We're going to make some pepper rings.
Okay.
So you just simple.
Slice them up. Easy enough to do. And really, all these fresh ingredients, really make what this salad's going to be. Really, you can really taste the different flavors. You said you got the tomatoes from
Confrita Farms.
Confrita Farms, which is great.
They're really, really good tomatoes.
If you have tomatoes in your backyard and you're wondering what you can do with them, a lot of people will make a traditional, just a regular salad at home. But a Greek salad really has great flavor to it.
Look at that.
Looks great.
Come on.
Yeah. That gorgeous. With a little of the cheese on it. A little salt and pepper.
Olive oil.
You know what?
You can't leave out the olive oil.
Absolutely. Then I'll be very happy.
Let's see. Just going to core it a little bit.
Okay. And what kind of tomatoes are these? Do you prefer using one tomato, like one sort of tomato over another?
I prefer what's in season.
Oh, okay.
Because these be fresh from the farm, like we said earlier.
They're sure.
Just pure delicious tomatoes.
Okay. All right. Just going to slice these up here.
Yep. Just going to wedge them a little bit.
Careful with that.
Try not to cut myself.
that'd be good. That'd be good. Just cutting that up. And then you also have some of the other ingredients, too, because you've got the Kalamata olives, and then even this olive oil, too, which really makes the flavor of this salad.
It brings it all together, because we use a healthy amount of olive oil to dress the salad, plus a little red wine vinegar.
Okay.
And the oregano just brightens up the whole dish.
Sounds good to me. All right, and you also have this just regular red onion.
Oh, yeah, regular red onion. Just going to julienne it a little bit.
Okay.
Try to use some fancy culinary terms, but
that's all right. It's okay. Cut that up. I love red onions too. Even the red onions have such a great taste as well.
See, I brought everything you love.
You do. You're a hero today.
Well, I'm a hero every day.
All right, we got we're going to put this together in just a little bit. The restaurant is a great restaurant. They're always busy. Got a lot of things going on. We'll talk about what the menu looks like for this season. Back to you. Kitchen this morning. Chef Phil is here from Rosalina. Greek salad, Bovis olive oil is on the menu today. He's already chopped up a lot of the fresh ingredients. Tell everyone what you've got here.
Well, we got some julienne red onions, some Didoni feta cheese, like we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
Yeah, confrita farm tomatoes, some green pepper rings, and some nice English cucumbers.
Okay, sounds good. Now, a lot of people at home, they'll make a traditional salad. They'll put lettuce in there. You don't need this.
No lettuce at all for this.
Okay, so you've got everything chopped up. Let's put this together because you have some other ingredients over here that we're going to put on it as well.
First, we're going to line the plate with some tomatoes.
Okay.
Make it big enough for you guys. So.
Sounds good.
So you don't fight over it.
Yeah, we love that.
We're going to go cucumbers. We're just right in the middle here.
All right.
Gonna salt these. Get a layer of the flavors.
I love them. Yeah, yeah. I'm a salt guy anyway, so.
Well, here comes the peppers.
Mm-hmm.
And then the red onions.
Okay. Some of that on there.
Oh yeah. Gotta get it right on top there.
Okay.
So now we're gonna go to our big pile of goodies over here.
So put this, some of this over here. Bring this over here for you.
So. Your favorite?
My favorite, Kalamata olives. I'm going to take some of these out of here now.
Oh, you can take whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
And just put them in the little holes.
Okay.
It's basically how we plate it at the restaurant, just on a bigger scale.
Right. And a lot of people, too. I mean, even the capers, too, add a great... I mean, they have a lot of salty flavor as it is.
Yeah, they
do. That just adds... I mean, between this and the feta cheese and everything else, there's a lot of... You don't really need too much salt on here,
you,
but...
You don't, but it helps bring out the flavor.
It does help bring out the flavor, because I love even the capers, too.
Oh, course. So just gonna sprinkle the capers around here.
Mm-hmm.
Give you a little extra because
we like it.
Why not? Got nice peppers.
I love them too.
You just love everything.
I do. Well, today you made me really happy. Yeah, I do.
So
a little more salt on there.
Then
I'll bring that up with for you.
The oregano.
Okay.
We actually just got this back from Greece when Tom and Lauren went over there.
Right.
So,
so that's authentic.
Fresh pick from the mountains.
That's authentic stuff.
You can't get better than that.
Right.
So, feta cheese.
Now, tell everyone about the feta cheese as well, because you have this tub of feta here.
Oh, yes.
Why do you guys like using that?
Well, it's a lot higher in fat, like we were talking about earlier, and it gives it a lot creamier of a taste than like most fetas you find in like the grocery store.
Some of them are kind of almost dry at some points.
Definitely really dry. But this isn't really dry at all. Plates up very nicely and stays together, doesn't like crumble.
Okay.
So it's more like, it's kind of like a taste of like cream cheese mixed with how you eat a feta.
All right. You know what? I'm gonna grab this knife because I want to.
You gotta get in on
it. I'm gonna get a little piece of this and give this a shot while you're doing this. All right. While we do this and while you're taking a look at this, because you also want to add some of the olive oil on it too.
Oh, yes,
what's
definitely
so special about the olive oil?
Well, the olive oil has been Tom Bovis's family farm for over 150 years. And it's from the Kalamata region of Greece.
Okay.
Which actually has the best olives for olive oil.
Oh, really? Okay.
In the world. And they're also the highest consumers of olive oil.
Oh, okay. All right.
So you got it.
So that's what you use. And the salad alone, it looks great.
Oh, yeah. Well,
I'm going to give this salad a taste.
Well, let me dress it for you.
Oh, you're going to put a little dressing on there? All right. I'll scoop.
Can't leave the olive oil.
While we're doing that. Give everybody the address of the restaurant itself.
We're located at 50 Aborn Street in downtown Providence, Rhode Island.
Okay.
And we're an Italian-inspired restaurant. We're mixed into like some Greek influences, Mediterranean influences.
So you got a lot going on. This is a great recipe, a lot of fresh ingredients from Restaurant Rosalina. And if you want all the information and the recipe for this, all you have to do, head over to roadshow.com.